It's looking like Gervonta Tank Davis versus Orlando Salido on the Mayweather-McGregor card. Stay tuned. Boxing Eagle here. If you like this video, make sure you hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon on the top of your screen to get notified when the latest new content drops. One. What up, fight world? It's your boy Ego, and I'm back with some more boxing. Make sure you smash the like button, also subscribe to the channel for the latest and greatest in boxing. We working. Shout out to everybody for the Patreon, patrons, super chats, the donations. Let's get this. Now, the talk of the town, everybody's talking about it. Gervonta Tank Davis versus Orlando Salido. It looks like it's a done deal. Now, I gotta say it looks like it because I haven't heard any actual confirmation, but I did a video in the past and it looks like this was the game plan all along, right? So this is something that's been in the works. Most people have been talking about and buzzing about. I even talked about it in regards to Lomachenko, which I'm gonna get to in this video. So I just want to make it an updated video. They've released the press tour for starters. It's a world tour. They start in Los Angeles at the Staples Center Tuesday. And then also they're gonna be in Toronto, then New York, then London. Right, so the whole week they're making stops. Great publicity. This is why, to me, like Golden Boy, Oscar, Bernard Hopkins, they're upset because now this fight is gaining traction because they're doing a press tour, and I'm pretty sure that's gonna be turned up. You'll do fucking none,
Mayweather. I don't know what you're thinking, Floyd.
You know what I mean? Connor's gonna do his piece, his bit, and then Mayweather's gonna do his shtick, and fights like Tank Davis versus Salido. Count me in. That's a dope fight. So I'll make another video as soon as it gets officially confirmed. Like, I see it on Mayweather Promotions. I've been on their Instagram and I haven't seen nothing from Floyd, but it looks like this has been in the works for a minute. Salido, all of a sudden, the fight with Lomachenko fell out, and this was what it looked like they were working on. And just to give you guys a little bit more, the fight with Tank Davis, he actually, on his verified social media page, he posted a graphic someone made of him and Floyd, and it said August 26th. So for sure he's fighting, and he just posted that a few hours ago. So he's definitely fighting on the card. And like I said, the rumored opponent has been Salido. That's the only person that I was really hearing. And like I said, if it changes, I'll make an updated video. But I really like this fight. Very bad for Lomachenko. Very bad. Now, you guys can say whatever you want. Oh, if Lomachenko would fight Tank Davis, he'd beat him, this and that. But the fact is, if this is the case, the Tank Davis, being 22 years old, his second title defense, taking on a veteran like Salido, this can show us something. Meanwhile, Vasyl Lomachenko is fighting on ESPN, and he's fighting against a guy off of a loss in a lighter division, Miguel Madariaga. You could say whatever you want. You could say, but Loma, he fought Salido and Gary Russell. I'm just talking about their upcoming fights, not the totality of their body of work. Because at the end of the day, if you really want to compare, Tank Davis is only 22. Lomachenko has 396 amateur fights. So he came into the pro rankings already advanced because he had so much amateur experience. Plus, he did like an offshoot before he turned pro. He was in this kind of world boxing league, so he has experience from that too. But I like this fight for Tank Davis. He's a young scrapper. He looks focused, he looks hungry. His last two performances made me even more of a fan. So shout out to my dude Tank. Jose Pedraza, I was impressed with his confidence and composure. I thought Pedraza had a dumb game plan. He was doing too much. He was making them noises. He was doing all kinds of weird noises, and Tank Davis was like, what is you doing all that for? And end up stopping him, the first to stop him as a champion. Pedraza did have some, both Tank Davis' last opponents have been taller. So I think Salido will probably be the guy who's closer to Tank Davis's height. Both guys have power. Salido, definitely a veteran, been in there with Robert the Ghost Guerrero, Juan Manuel Marquez, Mikey Garcia, Vasyl Lomachenko, and a bunch of other guys like Gamboa. So this is a good fight. And the reason I say it's bad for Lomachenko is, one, if Tank Davis is fighting Salido, that he has the better opponent as opposed to Miguel Mariaga, who has two losses, and in both of those losses he's been knocked down. The other reason is because if Tank Davis is able to beat Salido, especially if it's an emphatic victory like his last two fights, right? Or actually, I think he's had all knockouts except for one. So if he's able to pull that out and actually stop Salido, it looks real bad for Lomachenko, because Lomachenko, he fought Salido, I want to say, what year was that? Maybe 2014. And he has never rematched him. And if you let somebody, like I say, I keep saying this phrase, if you let Tank Davis handle your light work, which, you know what I mean, a lot of people will feel Lomachenko could beat Salido at this point. I don't know, but you didn't do it. So if you let Tank Davis, he's still in your shine. You know what I mean? That's just how the game goes, how the cookie crumbles. And I thought Lomachenko, that's a missed opportunity. This is the guy that beat you. You've advanced. Now you're fighting on ESPN against a guy in a lighter weight class and a guy who's coming off of a loss. And like I said, if Tank Davis beats Salido, then that's a missed opportunity. Because, yeah, I'm looking at right now, March 1st, 2014 is when Vasyl Lomachenko lost to Salido. So he's had 3 years to try to avenge that. But instead, Salido fought other people like Rocky Martinez, and now it looks like he's going to face Tank Davis. So after that point, if Tank Davis, like, let's say he destroys him, then who's going to want to see Lomachenko versus Salido? You know what I mean? So that's the thing with boxing, man. You got to get it while the getting is good. There's been a lot of marquee fights, like, let's say, Mikey Garcia versus Gamboa. I really, as a boxing fan, truly wanted to see that back when Mikey was with Top Rank. Now, I would not want to see that because so much has changed. Mikey's still doing good for himself, but Gamboa just quit on the stool in his last fight, so I don't want to see that. You know what I mean? And again, if Lomachenko, I wanted to see him rematch Salido to see how far he's advanced and what he's learned from that loss, if he can beat that style. So if he lets someone else beat that style, especially by stoppage, then that kind of steals the thunder from that. And then, like, you're going to beat a Salido who's been in wars, and then on top of that, maybe get stopped. But shout out to Tank. Shout out to Mayweather. Again, this is why Golden Boy and B-Hop are upset, because this card and this event, and it is that. It is an event. It's not just boxing. You got a UFC fighter, but if they put this on, I'm thinking this is a good card. This will help sell the card, right? Tank Davis is the young, flashy next Mayweather, so to speak. That's what they build him as. And he has an exciting style, southpaw. So hopefully this goes down. I'll keep you guys updated if this changes or if there's any modifications. Let me know your thoughts. Can Tank Davis beat Salido? Salido is definitely a veteran. I like this for a title defense. It shows that he's willing to fight whoever. We already knew that about Salido, but we now know that about Tank Davis. He went to the UK, stomped his opponent, easy work, came back, and then fight Salido. That's a big card. You know what I mean? Nobody wants to lose on a big card with million plus viewership. Make sure you share the video, like the video as always. Hate, comment, and subscribe. Till next video is Ego signing off. So if you enjoyed this video and want more content like this on the channel, you can show your appreciation by going to the PayPal donate button or the YouTube support button. And you can donate any amount that you feel is equivalent to the value of this video. Much more to come. Thank you guys for your support. Boxing Ego, the future of boxing.